All right, so color me embarrassed yet again, red-faced because of a hole in my knowledge of music history. That is Laura Nyro. Laura Nyro, you're looking at right there, lovely lady. Never heard of her before until Bobby, one of my favorite subscribers, Bobby357, told me about her. Is there supposed to be a magnum on the end of 357, Bobby? Okay, just curious. Anyway, so Bobby suggested that I do a mashup of Laura Nyro and Three Dog Night on the song Eli's Coming. And I'm like, who the hell is Laura Nyro? Well, it turns out Laura's the one who wrote the song in 1967. She performed it first, recorded it first in 68. Three Dog Night, of course, 69, famous. I think it went to number 4 with Three Dog Night on the charts. And so I'm like, wow, okay, damn. Then I look into Laura Nyro. Turns out she is famous in the music industry itself. She's in the Hall of Fame, the Music Hall of Fame. She unfortunately died at the age of 49. You ought to read the list of music performers who were influenced by her, who respected her. Elton John, Cyndi Lauper, Barbara Streisand. Just go on down the list. There's just dozens of them. And I'm like, wow, how did I not know about this woman? So she was from the Bronx, and she actually got out of the music industry when she was about 24. She was evidently a bit of an introvert, did not want to go on TV for TV talk shows, stuff like that, but wrote a bunch of famous songs, Wedding Bell Blues, by the Fifth Dimension, and many others. Barbara Streisand and others recorded her music, her lyrics, her songs. So she was famous in the industry. I just can't believe I've never heard of her before. I'm really looking forward to this. In order to put this mashup together, I had to hear a few seconds of her voice. I really liked it, but I haven't heard this song by her. Of course, I know the Three Dog Night song. I mean, I was a kid when they were famous, Three Dog Night between 69 and 75. Three number one songs, 20 or so top 40 hits. I was running around the house singing their songs. My mom and I were running around the house singing their songs. So this will be really interesting to see the takes. Just from the snippet, tiny snippet I heard, it sounds like it's going to be considerably different, the two takes. So I've got it divided up into three segments. So let's jump into this, and let's start with Laura. And it's her song, Eli's Coming, Here We Go. Eli's coming. Wow, that's nice. Love how she dragged that out. Wow. Been a while since I've heard this. It's really nice. Better hide your heart. Eli's coming, better walk, walk. Okay. All right. So that's the first segment. Wow. Wow. You know, what actually surprises me is how similar they are. The background voices, the general tempo. Three Dog Night has a little bit more power with the drums and everything. I love Laura's voice, and I don't know if that's her backup, if that's her voice in the backup that's really nice, sort of soaring over the top. I mean, I almost hate to say it, but the difference in these two is female and male. I mean, she comes in with this just almost sort of pleading and what's it's almost sort of plaintive. And then she gets strong. And it has a little bit of a sort of jazzy feel to it, which I really liked. But then she comes in strong with it. But her voice makes it so different from Three Dog Nights, even though they have like sort of they have I've always loved their voices, but they have that a little bit of a falsetto and everything. But the Three Dog Night comes in with that sort of masculine overdrive. So I think that's the main difference, really. But really, what I think is really interesting about this is the similarities. I mean, Three Dog Night really sounds very much in their rendition like Laura's rendition. So I could be wrong on that. And Bobby, you and others, tell me what I'm missing on this. So, oh, another thing about this is the Three Dog Night version is more than a minute shorter. So I'm not sure why that's going to be the case on this. So I guess we'll find out in these segments to come. But yeah, so I'm not sure what else to say yet. So let's keep going with this next segment.
You never get away, no, you never get away from the burning.
Okay, I just want to say real quick, boy, that has such a late 60s feel to it. You know, that sort of mild drum in the background and the guitar and the piano and just kind of that sort of almost sort of spacey late 60s feel to it. But I really like the pace on this. And of course, it's just one message that's coming through. But anyway, let's Eli's coming. You better hide your heart, girl. So let's listen to Three Dog Night's version on that segment.
You never get away, no, you never get away
60s.
from the bomb and the heartache. I walk to the bottom of the bay. Everywhere I go, though, Eliza coming. But she never got away. Eliza coming. She don't fight, she never got away. Eliza coming. She was coming to get you. She don't fight, she don't fight, she never got away.
Okay, wow. Gosh. Gosh. I mean, it's so actually similar to Laura's version. I mean, you got the sort of keyboard, you got the keyboards going on. You got the light drums, the background vocals, even the pacing really on this segment is very similar. I think really I like Laura's version more than I do Three Dog Night's. I think it's maybe her voice and the energy that she's, I mean, obviously Three Dog Night's putting a lot of energy into it, but it almost seems a little bit sort of confused in a way. And I know that's sort of the mental mindset of what this song is trying to get across. You're trying to get away, hide your heart, girl. Go to the Palo by the Bay, you know, but you can't get away. You can't get away. So that angst is getting across on the Three Dog Night version. And it's also getting across on Laura's version as well, but her version is a little bit more sonorous. It's a little bit more, it's got, the melody seems to stay together better for me with her version. The Three Dog Night version, and even as a kid and later on, I've always thought it was just a little bit too like scattered, almost frenzied. Frenzied, I think, is a better word. And maybe, I guess that's their interpretation. Hers has a little bit of that, but not quite as much. So yeah, so let's listen to this last segment and just see. I think this last segment by Three Dog Night is much shorter, if I recall. So here we go with Laura again. Could just see her sitting there saying that. All right, before we go to Three Dog Night on that segment, I just want to say I really like how she slowed it up, gave it melody, gave it, after all the sort of frenzy of the first part, she comes, it's like she's coming to grips with it and is settled. And I like that. I like that switch up very much. It's not that fast frenzied, better hide your heart. And then the backup vocals, I don't know if that's her, if it's somebody else. I wish I knew that, but that's extraordinary. It's got that 60s synth in there, which sometimes I'm not crazy about, but I really like it here. But the main thing is I just really like how it slows down and gives you a sort of, do you feel like there's a finality and comfort with her? And I like that. All right, so let's go. You better hide, somebody hide, you got to hide. interesting thing with that is that Three Dog Night actually ended up doing the actual lyrics on the end of the song, unlike Laura, who actually did not do all the lyrics on her own song. So Three Dog Night did that last one where it's hide it, she can hide it, hide it, hide it, be better, and then very end on the oh no. So yeah, so they ended up doing, and theirs is shorter. So I think they skipped the second verse, a lot of the second verse. Anyway, gosh, I think it's going to depend on my mood which one I want to listen to, because obviously Three Dog Night kept it going, kept that pace going, kept the frenzy going there at the end, which makes the whole song for them thematic. It's almost, for me, it's like some scene in a movie where somebody's running through the entire song. They're running to get away from somebody. You got to hide your heart, but you can't get away. You can't get away. And hers, it's like she's running for the first two stanzas, and then she's like, okay, now I'm going to stop running. And you can catch up with me if you want. But yeah, I'm going to hide my heart, but I'm just going to sit right here and do that. That's the feeling I got from her version. So it's going to depend on my mood which one I want to listen to, which is a compliment to both of them. And of course, that's the great thing about renditions, is because you get now alternatives to the original. So I really like this. I really like Laura's voice. There's a lot of confidence in her projection and her music making. And I think she was only about 21 or 22, 21, I think, when she did this, which is pretty extraordinary. Not just her writing, but her musical ability, her vocals, and her music making. But one thing I want to say about this song, as far as lyrics go, is that there are a few songs that just drive home one point and drive it home for the entire song, saying almost the same thing over and over with just a little bit of nuanced differences. This is one. It does it, and it does it well. So my hat's off to Laura for being able to do that with lyrics, and then come across so magnificently, and the nuanced changes she did with the expression of it and the backup vocals and everything. So I think that's the main thing, is just it's so different at the end, where the first two segments seem very similar on synth, piano, guitar, and even the, was it castanets, I think, in the background? No, it wasn't castanets. It was, gosh, I can't remember. Not bongos either. Anyway, but anyway, so yeah. Yeah, I think that's it. So I'll look forward to seeing what y'all say about this. And thanks to Bobby again for this recommendation. I'll catch y'all soon. Take care of yourselves. Bye now.